We have reached a point in time we affectionately call the OTR Pub Quiz. It's the world-renowned OTR Pub Quiz that I have been holding in my jacket pocket. Are you ready?
I've been looking forward to this all year.
No, all year, he says. Yeah. Right.
Liar, liar, pants
right,
on
right.
fire.
Okay, as we mentioned, you're a doctor, you're a soldier. So we're going to start with the classic TV series, MASH.
Oh, great.
That was on TV before you were born, though, probably, right? Hawkeye Pierce, played by Alan Alda, is a central character in the show. Take a look at the screen. What is Hawkeye Pierce's real name? Is it Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, or Alexander Hamilton?
That's a great question, and I don't know, but I can tell you that Alexander Hamilton is a hero of mine, so I'm going to go with C.
It is Benjamin. I like your logic, but it's Benjamin Franklin. It Benjamin Franklin Pierce is Hawkeye Pierce's real name. I could never remember that. Question two. You're a South End resident, as we mentioned. You represent the South End. Wally's Cafe is an iconic jazz club in the neighborhood. It opened in 1947 on the screen and had different names when it first opened. What was it? Wally's Bebop, Wally's Lighthouse, or Wally's Paradise?
Well, I live about a block away from Wally's. I'm going to say it's Wally's Paradise.
It was founded by Joseph L. Walcott, and it is still in the family, by the way.
Yeah,
it is. Very good. All right, now you're one for two. So let's go to the State House. The sacred cod hangs in the House chamber. It's a symbol of the state's maritime history. In 1933, it was briefly stolen by a prankster from a nearby college. Was it Harvard, was it MIT, or was it BU?
It's either A or B, and I'm going to go with the A.
You nailed it, right. Yeah. You were absolutely right on both fronts. It was either A or B, and it is A. It's Harvard. Harvard members of the Harvard Lampoon were responsible, of course. Police actually dragged the Charles River looking for it back in 1933. All right, here you go. This for a 75% mark here on the OTR Pub Quiz. You're a graduate
That's a
of the
C in medical school.
You're a graduate of the University of Texas. A longhorn steer named Bevo is the school's mascot. Believe it or not, the original mascot was not from the livestock family. So was it a cactus named Spike? Was it a tumbleweed named Tumbles? Or was it a pit bull terrier named Pig?
I'm going to go with cactus.
I thought that too when we rehearsed this.
It's the pit bull terrier
named Pig.
That is the most strange un-Texas thing like that.
Right! That's exactly what I thought. Very good, very good, very good.
But this was way before you went to school.
right.
Okay, back to the more serious business. Two of the biggest divides between Wu and Asabi George are rent control and a free tea. Now, if Wu is elected and tries to change either, she'll need Beacon Hill, obviously, to make it happen, where you spend at least part of your day. As a state legislator, do you see any chance of either of them getting any traction at the State House?
Well, I think these are conversations that will be had with, you know, should Michelle become the mayor of Boston. And I think folks on Beacon Hill are open to discussion. But these are very challenging situations, and I think to free the tea, it's going to require a significant amount of money. And so we have to remember the tea isn't just impacting Boston or the MBTA, it's impacting the whole Commonwealth. And so I think, you know, as a Beacon Hill legislator, there are 160 colleagues or 159 colleagues there. And I think, you know, what impacts Boston obviously has, you know, impacts the entire state. But I think, you know, it's going to be challenging to do, to say the least.
The leadership there has said, however, that they don't think there's much of a chance of doing anything major on rent control or on, you know, the T obviously is done by a group, by a board that's sort of out of the control of the legislature. I mean, do you sense that if she does anything, it's going to take years?
Well, it depends on what Michelle puts forward. You know, I'm still looking for specifics on, is there going to be a cap on rents? How is it going to alter the relationship between tenant and landlord? I think when she decides to put forward a proposal, then folks on Beacon Hill will take a look at it and decide whether that is appropriate for the city of Boston or not.
I wanted to touch on two things before we said thank you and goodbye. Number one is, what's the future for Jon Santiago? I mean, you wear so many hats, you do so many things, you ran for mayor this time. What's the future?
I am most excited about being a father. And the next couple months, you know, as we progress down those 9 months of pregnancy, we're excited about it. It's our first one. We're having a baby boy. And for right now, I'm excited about being a legislator and a physician. You know, I love my job in the hospital, caring for patients. This COVID pandemic has put things in perspective. I'm excited about doing the work in the legislature, learning how to, whether it's healthcare bills, whether it's behavioral health, whether it's, you know, housing. I mean, I have so many priorities that I want to get done as a legislator and as a physician that there's so much work to do. And I'm proud that the leadership on Beacon Hill and, you know, we saw they've done incredible things throughout the pandemic. and most recently, just this past week, releasing the ARPA funds, really a dedication to addressing equity mm-hmm. in an inclusive and in a transparent way, led mm-hmm. by Speaker Mariano and the folks like Representative Mikowicz. I'm looking forward to partnering with them for the next couple of years and getting things done.
So what I heard is calling him Representative Santiago or Dr. Santiago. No. Dad is the important thing.
Yeah,
right?
To me, that's most important right now.
Great to see you. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks for coming in. Our thanks to Jon Santiago for being with us this morning on The Record.